Is NASA ever going back to the moon without the help of Elon Musk?
According to NASA Administrator Bill Nelson, yes, it's just, you know, it's going to take a little bit longer. So as you already mentioned, we're now looking at U.S. astronauts returning to the moon, landing on the moon now in mid-2027 instead of 2026. And similarly, the mission that precedes that, which is a flyby mission, that is now pushed back till 2026 instead of next year.
Mm-hmm. Boy, well, this is a Boeing project, correct? Boeing stranded a couple of astronauts in space and they haven't gotten home yet. How does Boeing right the ship on its space program?
Well, just to be clear, that the issue here is not necessarily with Boeing. The concern at the moment has to do largely with the heat shield, which is something that is made by Lockheed Martin. So that's the big concern at the moment, and that's the reason that NASA Administrator Bill Nelson gave in explaining the delay, that they want to make sure that they get everything right with the heat shield. One thing that we should also point out is that Bill Nelson did say that even with the delay, this will still put the U.S. Sending people back to the moon before China gets there. China has said that they want to be there by 2030. Nelson said we're still going to get there before them.
This is just a day after, by the way, President-elect Trump named the next NASA administrator, as we told you around this time yesterday, Jared Isaacman, a former astronaut, be the first former astronaut to run the agency. What would the next phase of NASA look like? And are all the plans we just heard about today going to be at the mercy of the next administrator?
Well, it is a good point that, you know, things potentially could be in flux. Of course, Elon Musk is very close to President-elect Trump. Elon Musk has talked extensively about his goal of sending people to Mars. President-elect Trump has also said in the past that he's very interested in Mars. So there is a question about just how much the U.S. pushes ahead with its moon plans. Making a big pivot would be a huge change and would involve quite a lot in order to make that happen. So I don't think it's way too early to say that Artemis isn't happening. But you're right that with new administration coming in, there are a lot of question marks about what comes next.
Yeah, we've certainly seen that movie before. Shares of Lockheed, by the way, down fractionally, just over a dollar, about a quarter of 1%. How much of a share of Lockheed's business is involved in the Artemis program?
Lockheed is making the heat shield. They also are involved in the International Space Station. I misspoke there. That's not Lockheed Martin. That's Northrop Grumman. The key thing with them is the heat shield for this mission.
And as far as Boeing is concerned and its involvement here in the Artemis program, when are these astronauts coming home? Is it still February? SpaceX apparently will give them a trip back?
That is the plan, yes. So the two astronauts who went up there on the Boeing spacecraft earlier this year, they are scheduled to return on a SpaceX spacecraft in February. So it will take what was originally planned to be a mission for about a week to well over half a year.